I have been teaching the Elk Grove Unified School District for 33 years, and this is my 33rd year in first grade. They're going to make me do it till I do it right. Every time I get close, they change the rules. I figure I got really close one day because that Common Core came in. They changed all the rules, so I must have been getting something right. All right, what I would like for us to do today is to take some, find some ways that we can practice some math skills that are really fun, really engaging, really entertaining for the kids. When I've done this workshop with some of my BITSA people, they're kind of like, yeah, but what if my principal walks in and I'm playing a game? All of these are more practice for the standards, okay? There's not any fluff in here, okay? And that's what we're going to talk about as we go through and practice some of these games. Now, what you have on your desk in front of you is there's this packet here, and these are the instructions for all of the games that I'm going to teach you today. Well, there's more games that I'm going to have time to teach you today, okay? This right here, the white packet, these are black line masters of things, okay? So if you do like some of this stuff and you want to try it out, here's the things for you to run off, and those are all in white so that they're easy for you to run off. This one is also part of that, it just didn't make it into the paperclip. And then you have your evaluation, which you do need to turn these in today to get credit for being here, okay? So don't give up half a Saturday and not get credit for it. Make sure you turn these in. Alrighty, so getting started. What I'd like to start with is a game that is called, oh no, the first one I want to start with is the puzzles. In the middle of your groups, you're going to find some of these. Some of you have four at a group, some only have three because I've only made enough for my own class and there's more than 24 kids in here, obviously. But one thing I want you to notice as you're looking at these in within your group is one of the management things that I have with this, okay? Notice that I tried really hard to make sure that the two puzzles that are the same color are not at the same group. Okay, that's just my little organization for this. All right, as I make them as many different colors as I can, when I pass them out, I try to make sure the same color's right, not right next to each other, so they're not going to get them confused. Go ahead and grab one, dump it out. You are trying to make the 120 chart. So go ahead and take it out, see how you do. So talk to me and each other about what kinds of skills are we looking at here? Where could this fit into your curriculum? What do you need to know? What do they need to find out? Don't you hate those questions? Knowing how to count would be good. Problem solving. Plus 10, minus 10. What comes first? What comes next? All right, so do this, are you guys pretty good on this one? Got it? Motor skills, yes. All right, go ahead and put those back into the baggies. Kind of check around, make sure you got all the pieces back into the baggies. And you just put those back in the center of your tables, please. And after, as one kid will finish a puzzle, I'll say, okay, go switch with that person over there. You get done, go switch with that person over there. They just keep trading them around until they've done four or five of them, until the time is up. Put them away, now it's time to move on. The next one I would like to share with you. Most of you should have in the middle of your tables two baggies that have teddy bears in them. So right now you need to pick a partner at your group. Normally, of course, with the kids, I would pick their partners to make sure they all have one. But you guys are adults, so just pick a buddy. And the two of you will have one baggie. Please take out, for right now, I would like you to take out 8. Okay? That's all you're going to need to start this game. This game is written for you in your packet. It's called Don't Take the Last One. Now, yesterday I was telling my kids, because they were saying, oh, goody, there's no school tomorrow. And I said, oh, yeah, but there is for me. And I said, yeah, I got to go be a teacher tomorrow, and I got to teach math games. And they said, ooh, which math games are you going to teach? I said, which one should I teach? This is one they came up with. They said, oh, you got to teach this one, Ms. Moore. This is a great one. This is called Don't Take the Last One. And as you might think, if you take the last one, you lose. Okay? You want to make sure the other person has to take the last one. Now, you can decide who's going to go first. It doesn't matter. I mean, with kids, of course, you would tell them how they're going to decide. Whoever's tallest gets to go first, whatever. But the way you play the game is when it is your turn, you may take one or you may take two. It is your choice which one you do. Take one or take two, and then it's the other person's turn. And obviously, you want to leave the last one for the other person to take. All right? Decide who's going to go first. And then go. When you're done playing, give me a thumbs up because I want to talk about some of the strategies you used. Take one. No, take one. All right, did anybody figure out a trick to this? Anybody get the trick? Anybody figure out the magic number? There is a trick. You're not going to tell the kids a trick, of course. Maybe, if you pay me. Anybody figure out the magic number? Four. Okay. If it gets down to four left, and you want it to be your turn. No, you want it to be the other person's turn. You want to leave four. Because then if they take two, you take one. If they take one, you take two. Okay? Don't tell the kids that. Let them figure it out. Okay? So far in first grade, they've never figured it out, just so you know. And I do have smart kids, really, I do. All right, now, ways that you could modify this game. Okay, so they've played this a couple of times, the noise level's getting kind of high. You say, okay, now take out two more bears. Do you have to change your strategy? Okay, do the what I just did too, they all start thinking, oh, if you go first, you always win. Okay, let the other person go first and see what happens. Okay? Obviously, you don't want to get much fewer than like six bears. Okay, I wouldn't go any less than six because then the game goes really fast. But also, do you have to use bears? No, you do not have to use bears. Whatever they've got in their desk. I mean, you've got kids that have got 10 pencils in their desk. You know you do. Come on, admit it. Okay? So they can take out pencils. They can, if they've got, my kids have a math bowl in their desk and it's got buttons in it. They can take out the buttons. If you've got tiles in their desk, they can take out the tiles. I mean, this is a game that I can play. You know, you've got those 4 minutes before you really can line up and go down to the cafeteria. This is a great one. A great one for that. Okay? They've got to do some planning. They've got to do some strategizing. So this is another one that's just really good for those reasoning skills, and it's also, you know, really fast, okay? All right, if you want to, go ahead and put those away for me, please. Number three is on page two. Looking at page two, I'm going to skip tens for right now. Tens is my all-time favorite game in the whole entire world, so we're going to end with that one. Looking on page number two, we have war games. I'm going to borrow you guys for just a second. At your tables, you will notice that you should have, hopefully, four decks of cards at each one of your groups. Now, these decks of cards are ace through 10, ace through 10. I've taken out all the face cards, mainly because first graders cannot remember, okay, is the king is a 13, is it 11, is it 12, and you know what, neither can I. So, I always blame it on the kids, but it's really me. So, I just do ace through 10, ace being a 1, okay? It's really nice if you can have them like all black cards on one and all red cards. It doesn't always work out that way. They eat them, you know they do. Those kids are hungry. So, but the management on this one is the backs of the cards. Okay, because you and your partner will be mixing the cards together and you want to get them back. So you want to make sure that the pairs do not have the same back. So when it's time to put the cards away, they can very quickly sort them back. Okay, so that's the trick to the management on the cards. The trick to collecting the cards is you have to have a husband who likes to go to Reno a lot. My husband and I used to go to Reno quite a bit. And while he's gambling, I'm not a gambler other than marrying him. And so while he was gambling, I would go around and buy cards. They'd have them, some of them you might notice have got holes punched in them. They've got the names of casinos on the back of them. So back in those days, because you probably noticed I'm a little old, back in those days they were like 50 cents, you know. I know every now and then, like Dollar Tree will have maybe two decks for a buck, which you're back to 50 cents again. I do know that at Costco they'll sell a great big thing, but I think the backs are all the same. So you've got to be careful on that. What you might want to do is maybe as a team buy two or three of those and then swap them around so you've got the different backs. Okay, so that's the management of these. So go ahead, pick a deck of cards. Try not to lose the rubber band, which is something first graders are good at. And what you're going to be doing is you're going to, first of all, play war. Now, if you think back to when you were a kid and you played war, you turn over the top card. Whoever has the highest card gets to take the two cards, right? Well, because you're only playing with 20 cards, you're still going to do that. But if you get the same card, the way we used to play was you put down three more cards and then turned one over and you win all of those. We don't have enough cards for that. So if you get the same number, you just turn over another card, one more. And whoever has the highest card takes all four of the cards, okay? So there are four different games that I like to play with this. One is called High War. Whoever has the highest card takes the card. Low War. Whoever has the lowest card takes the cards, okay? The second one that I like to play is called Place Value War. That is where you take two cards off the top and, can I borrow two? So I have a six and an eight. If I'm playing high, I'm gonna switch it around so it's an 86. I wanna make the highest number I can make. If I'm playing low place value, then I'm gonna make a 68 because I wanna have the lowest number, okay? Now, as you're getting into second grade or third grade or higher, take three cards, make it into the hundreds, okay? You could put two decks of cards together, so this person has two decks, this person has two decks. You could do that. You do need to make a decision when you're playing the place value one of what the 10 is going to be. Is the 10 100? Is it just a 10? And they add? You need to decide, okay? So for right now, you and your partner decide which war you're going to play. High war, low war, place value war, high or low. And go ahead and play at least one round so that you if you have any questions, you can ask me. All right, ladies and gentlemen, could you go ahead and resort the cards, put the rubber band back on them, please? Okay, we did have some questions about that 10. You know, if you're a kindergarten teacher, first grade teacher, early on in the second grade, when you're not really sure if they can add the 100, add the 10 to it, take the 10s out, just take them out. You know, just tell the kids, yeah, put these aside, we're not gonna use them right now. Okay, also you can start off the beginning of the year just doing plain war, you know, high, low war. Later on in the year, when you hit that wonderful, fabulous unit six and go math in first grade, pull out the place value war. I mean, you can bump up the intensity of it throughout the year, okay? Any other questions or anything about that one? Cool, moving on. All right, moving on to page number, I forgot to write down the page number. if you'll turn over to page four. I won't be able to hit all of these in an hour, guys. I'm gonna try to get as many as I can. Now, one of the things that I used to teach in first grade, but of course I don't anymore, is money. Yeah, I'm sure you second grade teachers are just thrilled with the fact that we don't talk about money anymore. And then you guys get dimes, nickels, and quarters within 2 days of each other. Yeah, I know these things. So. But when I was teaching money, I found that it was really difficult for my kids to change from counting 25s, now I gotta count 10s, now I gotta count 5s, now I gotta count 1s. And it was just really hard for them to make those transitions. So, a lot of these games I have begged, borrowed, stolen from other places. This one I invented myself, so I take full credit for this one. It's called Quick Flash. This is another one that, you know, when you're standing in line waiting to get into the assembly, when you're waiting to get in for lunch, whatever, you can do this one very quickly because all you need is your own fingers, okay? The important thing is I tell my kids, you got to watch me. No matter where I am, you got to watch me. So they're looking around, see if they can find me. So you're going to watch my hands, and you are going to count with me. This, of course, is a 10. This is a 5. This is a 5. Those are 1s, okay? Now, the first couple of times that I play this, I'm not going to mix up a whole lot, okay? But again, you can build the intensity of this one, okay? So counting with me. Ready? Go.
10, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 50, 60, 65.
Okay, get the idea of that one? What's really fun is to do this. You ready? Okay, we're starting over. And I always do this so they know we're starting over with a brand new number. Okay, ready? Here we go.
10, 20, 30, 35, 40, 45. 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 60, 70, 75, 80, 90, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99.
Oh, time to go. They hate that when you do that. Okay, but it just gets them used to that idea that you got to switch from tens to fives to ones to ones to tens to nickels and all of that. I have never figured out how to do quarters yet. Sorry, I'm working on trying to grow some more hands, but it just hasn't worked so far. Okay? Yes?
Do you ever go like, you know, you're at 32, mm-hmm. and then you flash 10 more and then you have to go 42?
I haven't done that with first graders yet. No, that's a good idea though. It really is. Yeah. Get them that 10 more. So yeah, that would be a great idea to do. Alrighty, so that is quick flash. The other one is Dominoes missing add-in on page 3, I believe it is. You should have at your groups 2 sets of dominoes. Okay, these dominoes that you see in front of you, one year, and unfortunately it was right about Christmas time, so I'm sorry if we just missed it, but 1 year they had these at Dollar Tree, and it was sets of double sixes. Okay, at Dollar Tree, and of course they were a dollar. Hello. So I went ahead and invested, $24, $25 with tax and everything, and bought these dominoes, okay, the nice hard ones. And again, if you'll notice, I tried to do some kind of a management system. If you look at the edge, I sat there with my little marker in front of my TV, and I colored them. So I tried to make sure that the same colors are not at the same group. Or right next to each other. If you're going to do some kind of games where the kids each have their own dominoes, you don't want to give the same color to right next to each other, okay? But if you're not, if you cannot find those, you cannot afford those, there's also paper dominoes. I bought these from Marcy Cook. How many of you are familiar with Marcy Cook? Don't you love Marcy Cook? Oh my gosh, I love that woman. Wish I had thought of the stuff she thought of, because you know what? I wouldn't be here today. I'd be in Hawaii. I'd be rich. So these are paper ones, and they're already color-coded. Now, back in the day when I purchased these, and it has been a while, guys, they were 40 cents a sheet. Okay, they may be 50 cents a sheet now. I don't know. But if you just Google Marcy Cook, C-O-O-K, you'll get to her website and you can buy these there. There's also, I'm sure that if you look online, you can just find a sheet, you know, a printout of the dominoes, and you can print them out yourselves and cut them out. That's so much fun. Don't you enjoy doing that? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I have permanent nerve damage right here from my first years as teaching because I cut out all my own borders, all my own. So anyway, but that's how you can get dominoes. I have to be honest, I don't use the dominoes as much as I used to, you know, time, but they are fun and the kids really do like them. Okay, they really enjoy doing stuff with them. So the game that I want to show you is with you and your buddy. This is a missing add-in, and I know they don't call it that anymore, but too bad, that's what I call it. Because, you know, I'm old and I'm used to it. Okay, so the way that you do that is, so I'm going to play first. I'm going to go first. I'm going to look, and I notice that my domino, when I add the two ends together, is 5. Okay, so now I'm going to take my little bitty first grade finger. I'm going to cover up one side, and I'm going to look at my partner and I'm going to say, it's 5. What am I covering up? Okay? And if they get it right, then they get to keep that domino. And then it is now my partner's turn. And now they're going to go in. They're going to get a domino. They're going to see how much is it together, cover up one side, and tell you. Okay? So go ahead and play that for just a couple of minutes. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, back at the ranch. One of the other really fun things to do with dominoes is when you're going to give each child their own set of dominoes. Thanks, ladies. When you're going to give each kid their own set of dominoes, which I didn't put those out for you, but another idea that to just have them practice some really fast addition is they've got them all face up in front of them. And I know it looks like there's going to be a whole bunch of them there. And you start saying, okay, find the dominoes that add up to 1. Everybody go. How many can you find? They hold it up. Find all the dominoes that add up to 2. How many can you find? Okay. And finally, you do get to a point, and I can't remember what it is now, when you say, find all the dominoes that add up to 4. Oh, wait, there's more than 1. So then you say, well, how many can you find? So they are looking through every single domino, and they're adding both ends together, and they're trying to do it fast because they want to be the first one to hold it up. And so then it gets to a point, and then it starts going back down again where, you've got 5 or 6 dominoes that add up to 6, but then all of a sudden it starts going down as you add them up to 12. No, sorry. What did I, well, I used to do that actually just to make sure they had all their dominoes. could just be a domino addition, fast domino addition of just see how quickly they can find the dominoes that add up to that number. Okay? All right, if you'll go ahead and put those back into the baggies. I want to work a little bit on place value. Now, the first thing I want to show you is actually, I think, on the very last page. What page number is that? Page number six, place value mats. Now, those of you that have been around for a little while probably remember Mat Their Way. Y'all remember that? Didn't you love Mat Their Way? I really enjoyed Mat Their Way. This is something that I got from Mat Their Way. Those of you that are in first grade, I am going to start playing this in my classroom before I get to chapter 6. So like the week before chapter 6, I would do this with the kids, okay? At your groups, I think I only had enough folders that there's 2 or 3 of the orange folders. So if you want to open those, I'm not sure if I got 4 at each set or if there was just 3. Yeah, there was, because again, it was just a class set. So if you open that up, it should look a little bit like this. Okay? So you've got tens over here, you've got ones over here. As I'm going through this, I also want you to keep in mind that, oh no, that's the next game, sorry. What we're going to be doing here is I tell the kids, we are going to build numbers. Okay? We are going to find out what do numbers look like. How do you build them? And you know what I've always wondered? Why do we write numbers the way we do? Why do we write them that way? We're gonna find out today, okay? So here's the way we play the game. You're gonna need your ones cubes that are in the little trays in front of you. Every time I snap my fingers, that's gonna be our signal. You are going to put a cube on a square. Okay, you're gonna put a cube on a square when I snap my fingers. Don't put on a cube until I tell you to. Now, ready? We still have some more instructions, so listen carefully. Cubes do not go on the purple paper. Cubes do not go on the purple paper. Okay, that's a rule. Now, back on teacher talk here for just a second. I do make this and put it up so I can do it with the kids. I've taken these little tin sticks and little cubes and put little hot glued magnets on them, okay? I happen to have, because I've been around a while, a bunch of the plastic ones, but you all have these in your Go Math kits also, okay? So I'm not telling you run out and buy a whole set of these things. If you look around your schools, talk to some of your teachers that have been there a while. I'm trying to say that in a very nice way. Okay. Go talk to kinder. To me, is always my go-to people. I will go to kindergarten and ask them for stuff way before I go anywhere else because they've always got junk stashed away, okay? And they're usually pretty sharing. So go get a set of these, throw some magnets on the back of them. As far as the magnets go, you know how you get those business card magnets all the time in the mail or whatever? I just cut them up, glue them on, okay? Now, when you make this chart, you need to resist the temptation to laminate it. I know you're gonna wanna laminate it. We love laminating, we love smelling it, we love feeling it, we love chewing on it. It's our favorite thing. Don't do it, because if you laminate it, the magnets will not stick. It's too thick. These are just too lightweight, and the ones that are in the Go Math are even lighter weight, okay? So please don't laminate it, just don't do it, okay? Take my word for it. All right, so the other thing that you will need is some kind of a strip of paper. Now, I happen to be old enough that I have a lot of this stuff sitting around, the rolls of cash register tape, but any strip of paper will do. It's just got to be a skinny strip. You're going to put tens on one side, ones on the other, okay? All right, back into the kids side of it. All right, when I snap my fingers, you're going to put on one cube, okay? And then we're going to touch and read, all right? So let's try it. Put on one cube. Here's how we touch and read. Ready? Zero, tens, and one. Everybody touch and read. Zero, tens, and one. And what does that number one look like? Here we are. All right, so you built it. You see what it looks like? That's what it looks like over there. Ready? Go. Touch and read. Zero, tens, and two. And so we built it. You see what it looks like? Here it is. And I'm going to do this part really fast because I want to get you to the good part. I would definitely not do it this fast with my kids. Okay? Put on a cube. Touch and read. Zero, tens, and three. Put on a cube. Zero, tens, and four. Ready? Put on a cube. Zero, tens, and five. Put on a cube. Zero, tens, and six. Put on a cube. Zero, tens, and seven. You can be having conversations about bigger, smaller, all that kind of stuff, but we want to get to the good part. Put on a cube. Zero, tens, and eight. Zero, tens, and nine. Here comes the good part. Okay, the next two are the good parts. Ready? Put on a cube. Okay, now we're going to stop right here. And we need to, you notice that we've run out of room. Okay, we're going to want to put more on. So we're going to take all of these off. Notice it says trade for a 10 stick. So take these off. Take all of those off and pick up a 10 stick. Now, if you need to, prove to your kids that 10 of those is the same as this. Line them up next to each other so that they see that 10 of those tiny cubes equals this. You will have little kids sitting here going like this because of the lines on here, all right? But just show it to them. All right, take your 10 stick, put it over here where it says 10. Now we're going to touch and read. Ready, go. 1, 10, and 0 ones. What does that look like? And this happens every year. Every year I go, let's see what that looks like. Ready? 1, 10, 0 ones. And I always have some kid that goes, oh! Wow! I said, now do you see why we write our numbers the way we write them? Okay? 1, 10, 0 ones. Whoa, isn't that just the coolest thing? All right, ready? Now, where do the cubes go? On the blue side. Cube, not stick. Cube. Here we go. All right, touch and read. 1, 10, and 1. How do we write that? 1, 10, and 1. Amazing. Ready? Put on a cube. Touch and read. 1, 10, and 2 ones. Okay, I'm going to do a little bit fast here. Let's get put on two more for me. So you're looking like this when they don't fall off. Looking like that. So now you're going to have the conversation. Here it is, 110 and four ones. Is that the same as that? Why not? It's got a four and a one. That says four tens, doesn't it? Four tens and one, okay? So if this were, I always say jelly beans, but then I had a kid 1 year who said he didn't like jelly beans, so I switched to bubble gum. If this were bubble gums, which one would you want? Show me with your finger. Do you want the number on top or the number on bottom? Why? It's bigger, isn't it? It's got four tens, all right? So you got to remember how to write the numbers. How do we write these numbers? Okay? So I'm going to just stop here, but I keep going with this. Okay? And of course, it's really important when you get up into like the 30s and stuff, the 34, 43, 52, 25, which one do you want really? That kind of stuff. Okay? I go all the way to 100. Do I do it in one day? No. Not that foolish, but it usually takes about 3 to 4 days, okay? Now, when it is time to put everything away, I tell the kids, look at your board. Everybody take a picture of your board. I want to hear your camera go off. Close your eyes. Can you see that picture? Okay, what number are we on? We're on 14. How many tens? 110. How many ones? Four ones. So when we do this tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, do we have to go all the way back to the beginning? No, we don't have to go to the beginning. When you get your board tomorrow, how are you going to set it up? When I say, show me 14, what are you going to put on there? 110 and four ones. So that's kind of your management of how to get this going the next day. The first day, I can usually get to about 25. Okay, the next day, 50, maybe closer to 75, third and fourth day all the way to 100, okay? In some places, they also have the kids writing the numbers. I have found that their desks are just too small. They end up knocking things over and off, and I was just like, I'll do the writing, thank you, okay? So after you've gone through all of this and you've discussed all of the numbers, then you can say, all right, now I'm going to just give you your boards. How many of you have the hundreds charts that have the little cards in them that you can pull out of the pocket charts? If you don't have one of those, it's a good investment. If you don't have one, just run off some numbers. Or you can, you know, write it on their whiteboard as you run around the room really fast. But now we're going to take out our boards, they're blank, and I'm going to hand you one of those little cards like they have in the calendars. And you're going to build that number. Okay, so here's your number. Build that number. Okay? So everybody builds a different number. And then you walk around the room and have everybody talk about their number. What is your number? My number is 52. How many tens? Five. How many ones? Two. Okay? One thing that I've already started in my classroom is when I tell my kids, get out your phonics skills book, you are looking for page 79. What does a 79 look like? A 7 and a 9. How many tens? 7. How many ones? 9. Okay? I do that as I'm playing this game too. Okay, for 14. Everybody show me on your fingers. How many tens? How many ones? And I mix it up. How many ones? And you'll get kids doing this. Like, no, I said ones. Okay. All right, any questions about this one? All right, if you'll go ahead and put all of those things away, please. All right, the next one that I'm going to show you is called the trade game. That one is on page 4. This is one that I actually started playing back when I taught money. But now I don't do that anymore. Can you tell I miss teaching money? I like teaching money. It's fun. Yeah.
It's amazing how much they learned in first grade about money.
When we were year round, she and I were both on B track, and I was the first grade, she was the second grade. So she always got all my kids. And so she'd come back to me and go, really? Actually, she would call me in my classroom and say, okay, the kids are telling me something about a skinny L rule, and I don't know what that is. And so, yeah, she and I got along really well. So this next one, again, you can play this one with money as well as with the cubes. You are going to set a goal for the kids, okay? The goal is to have 4 10 sticks. Did I say 40?
No.
No. The goal is, if you're doing money, 4 dimes. Did I say 40 cents? No, because you want them to trade. You do not want them to end up with 40 ones cubes in front of them or 40 pennies. You want them to trade, okay? That's the name of the game, the trade game. So inside your little trays here, there should be a dice. I know it's called a die, but you know. Okay, there's probably only one, but we're running out of time, so I'm just gonna show you guys how to play this game very quickly. You'll have the kids set up in twos. Okay, most of these games are played with twos, and you're going to, you will roll the cube, you'll take that many cubes, okay? So go ahead, one person roll, you take that many. Okay, if you got 4, you take 4 ones cubes. Okay, then you always stop at the end of your turn and say, can I trade for a 10? If you've only got 4 sitting in front of you, can you trade for a 10? No. If you've got 6 sitting in front of you, can you trade for a 10? No. So then it's the next person's turn. Next person, roll. Take that many. Stop. Can I trade for a 10? No. Go ahead and next person's turn, they roll. Yes.
We're putting all of ours into one pile. There's 2 players.
You each get your own. Yeah, I'm sorry. Thank you for clarifying that. You each keep your own cubes, okay? Now, when it gets to be your turn again, you're gonna add your new cubes to your old cubes, okay? So if you had 4 before and you get 3 now, how many cubes do you have now? 7. Can you trade for a 10? No. So you just keep going around and around, rolling, trading, until somebody has what? 4 10 sticks. And I'll have kids say, Mrs. Moore, we're out of ones cubes. Can you bring me some more? And I look at them and they've got this huge pile in front of them. And I say, you need to trade. I am not giving you any more ones cubes. Trade them in, okay? The other thing that is really interesting is that when the kids roll a 6 in money, if you're playing with money, and they roll a 6, they'll take 6 pennies. As adults, we take the nickel and the penny. We've already traded it, okay? But they won't, all right? So, modifications of this one. You can make it higher. You know, now you're gonna go all the way to 6 10 sticks, okay? In money, it's a lot easier because you could just have dimes and pennies. Now add in the nickels, okay? Now add in the quarters, all right? Any questions about this game? Nope, okay. Go ahead and, if you took anything out, go ahead and put that back. I had a couple that I'm not gonna play with you even though I have the stuff out here. One is Battleship. You would take the 120 chart. Each person has a 120 chart in front of them, and I have one of those for you in your packet. And they would put up, and I call these offices in my classroom, it's just a folder like this, okay? So if you're gonna go first, you would put yours right here, okay? And your 120 chart is here, you have 120 chart here. Mm-hmm. Then they're gonna take, I have in the baggies those linkets. I hated those things. Man, they always got tangled up and you could never get them apart and everything, so I finally found a good use for them. Use them one at a time. And so when it's your turn, you're going to take the linket, you're going to put it on a number. Okay, it's her turn, she's going to put it here. Now she's going to describe her number to her partner. Okay, my number is 10 more than 42. So now the other person has to take their linket and put it on the number that they think it is. And they say, ready? You lift this up. Are they the same? Great. If they're not, she gets another turn. If they are the same, you just turn it over like that. Now it's the other person's turn, okay? But they're having to say something about their number. They've got to describe their number. My number has 6 tens and 7 ones, okay? Does that one make sense? Okay. I think that one is on page 5, Battleship. Battleship. You see why I named that Battleship? Yeah. All right. Folks, we've only got a few minutes left, so I want to show you how to play tens because it's my all-time favorite. So you can put everything down and just look right over here. To play tens, it's a whole class. It's the whole class, okay? So just go ahead and put everything down, put your eyeballs right over here. And what I've done is I've taken a deck of cards, I've taken out all of the face cards, okay? And what your job, what our job is to make tens. You may use one card or two cards to make a 10. I know you're gonna see three cards, four cards, five cards that'll make a 10. No, you're gonna add only one card, two cards to make a 10, okay? You start off with, I get four cards. I always go first because I'm the biggest. Maybe not in this class, but in my class, I'm the biggest. I know that's a surprise. All right, so then I'm gonna look and I'm gonna say, I think 7 and 3 makes 10. Always check. Make them check every time, okay? So we always start with the biggest number. Ready? 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so I get those. Now, I always have a kid collect the cards for the class, and I try to collect my own, and I always end up switching it. They correct me. All right, I have no more 10, so now it is your turn. If you see a 10 in class, I'd ask them to please raise their hand, and I would call on somebody, okay? But you guys just shout it out if you see a 10. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And of course, we're gonna go really fast. I would never go this fast in class. Never, okay? Do you see any more 10s?
No.
But what if they did? What if some kid says, yeah, 8 and 1, let's check. 8, 9, oh, really close, really close, okay? Always check. All right, so here now it's my turn. I don't see any 10s. Now it's your turn, you already have four cards, you get one more. See any 10s? Nope. My turn, I get another card. My turn, don't tell me the answers. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay? Oh, I forgot one thing, let's do that. All right, now, your turn. Here's your card.
8 and 2. 8, 9, 10,
there you go. All right, we're on it now. We're gonna go moving really fast so we get through in time. 9, 10. Now you will get two cards. Okay, there's only two up here. It's your turn. You can always have four. Tens?
9 and 1.
There you go. Good job. All right, my turn. 7, 8, 9, 10. Your turn. You get two cards.
Double 5 and 5.
And in my class, they would go 5 and 5 is 10. Again, we have a chant that we've learned for the doubles, and oh my gosh, it comes up all the time. All right, 9 and 1. You keep going.
9 and 1.
There you go. No tens.
8 and 2.
There you go. No tens, your turn.
8 and 2.
I'm whomping on you.
Now it's my turn. 10. Oh, they just think that is so cool. It's amazing.
6 and 4.
I get two cards. 7 and 3. You get two cards.
2 10.
Oh my goodness. They would have gone crazy right there, let me tell you. All right.
You can take more than one 10.
Yes, as long as there are 10s, they can take them. They take them both. They take all the 10s that they see. 6 and 4. Your turn.
10.
7 and 3. All right, here's the magic, so you don't want to miss this part. All right, so it's my turn. I should have four cards, but that's all the cards, okay? So I'm going to say 5 and 5. Now, before we started, I took a card away. There's one magic card sitting over here. Nobody has seen it. I haven't seen it. You haven't seen it. But you see there is a card, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Nothing up my sleeves. Yeah. All right, so there is a card over there. Now here's what I tell the kids. If you can all, you all have to agree, what is that card? If you all agree and you're correct, you get the two cards. If you cannot all agree, or if you are wrong, I get the two cards. Well, come on, you know what they want, okay? So I tell them, show me on your fingers. What do you think the mystery card is? Show me on your fingers. Everybody show me. Okay. So I want to know, why do you think the magic number is 8? Why? Okay, so what? Why do you think it's 8?
8 plus 2 is 10.
8 plus 2 is 10. Interesting. Interesting. Okay, and this student over here, and I'm sorry, but I'm going to pick on you. Why do you think the number is 10?
Because I think 8 and 2 is 10.
Okay, so you think our missing number is going to be 10, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. And you will get that. Every time I play this, the first time I play it, I have a kid who says it's 10. And I say, why do you think it's 10? Because we're playing 10s. Okay. I accept that answer. They gave me a reason. Okay. And if anybody's got other answers, I will ask them. You know, why do you think it's 6? Why do you think it's 5? And have them explain it. Okay? But then I remind them, guys, you have to all agree. You have to all agree. If you don't, I get the cards. Okay? So those of you who thought it was 10 or 6 or 5, are you willing to change your answers to 8? Because most of you thought it was 8. And I did. Last time I played this, I had a kid. Nope, not changing. Mm-mm. I'm standing my ground. Okay? So, all right, so you guys all think it's 8? Sure? Positive? Yep. And here's where I get to play the, you know, do you want to be a millionaire? Want to change your answer? Phone a friend? Final answer? Okay, and this is where my partner in the room next door, who's sitting right over there, Tandy, she and her class go, oh my gosh, what's going on over there? Because as soon as I finally go, all right, are you ready? Here it is. They go nuts. And I've got Tandy running through the door going, what are you people doing? But they do. They just cheer so loud when they get this card. Okay? But then you stop and say, but why was it 8? Because 8 and 2 makes 10, and we were playing 10s. Okay? Then you count your cards, and whoever has the most cards wins. You know, sometimes it is them. I mean, you know, it is kind of a luck of the draw here. Why do we play this? What is one of our biggest strategies? Make a 10. This card game also works for make a 9, take out the 10s. Make an 8, take out the 10s, take out the 9s. I wouldn't go much less than 5, okay, because then you don't have a whole lot of cards, all right? But you can play it, you know, for make an 8, make a 9, make a 7. Yes?
Where'd you get your cards?
Actually, I got these at Disneyland. But every now and then, I see a big deck like this at Dollar Tree. I've seen these at Target, you know, in the dollar section that just sucks you right in as soon as you walk in the door. My husband hates that section. You just have to look around for them. I'm sure if you go online, you could probably order them from Amazon, because Amazon owns the world, and I'm sure they've got them, okay? So that is my all-time favorite game. The kids love this game. All right, there are other games that are in your packets that unfortunately I didn't have a chance to get to. As far as Blackline Masters, I also gave you Masters for playing There are 3 or 4 different ones in there. Are you guys familiar on how to play that? You pass out the cards. And there's one card that says start card, so that person starts, and they read their card. I have 7. Who has 1, 10, and 3? So the person whose card says I have 13, they stand up. I have 13. Who has 4 10s and, you know, it's all written out for them, okay? And it goes all the way around to the final card, okay? And it's supposed to go fast, and that's the hard part with first graders is they all sit there, stare at the cards. Come on, guys, who's got 43? Come on, look at your card. Look at your partner's card. Do they have 43? Okay, so I get so that I set a timer. We're going to try to beat the timer in playing who has. Okay, and so that makes them want to make it go fast. Okay, glancing through your packets, was there anything else that maybe you had a question about that I didn't have a chance to cover? Anything? Okay? All right. Thank you.